Hi, I'm Tim. Welcome to our channel, and thanks for logging on. Today, we're discussing a variant of a watch I've often described as the best-kept secret in luxury divers. It's the Carl F. Bucherer Patravi Scubatec here in stainless steel and 18-karat rose gold. You can see and you can purchase this remarkably capable dive watch on our website. Subscribe to our YouTube channel if you enjoy these videos, and please click on the card in the upper right-hand corner of the screen at any time during this video to see our full sales listing for this watch with additional accessories included in the sale, high-resolution images for your desktop, and naturally complete pricing details for this Carl F. Bucherer Patravi Scubatec. Now, introduced at Baselworld 2014, the Scubatec represented a no-holds-barred venture into the dive watch segment by Carl F. Bucherer. For those who perhaps aren't familiar with this brand's parent company, Bucherer is the number one retailer of watches and jewelry in continental Europe. They are a $1 billion company with the resources to match on the watchmaking side. They build wonderful watches that almost no one's heard of. So you have unrivaled resources, backing, and stability behind the brand with design that is blue sky imagination, handsome, and feels two grades of luxury above its price point. So this watch offers quite a good deal. Let's start with the fit and the feel. 44.6 millimeters across the round of the case, not including the helium escape valve, the crown, or the crown guards. You might think that this would be too big for a small wrist. Au contraire, this is an easy watch to wear on my wrist. 16 centimeters in circumference, almost 45 millimeters in diameter, and there are no fit issues. As you can see from right overhead, the watch beautifully drapes its short and stubby lugs around your wrist, and the lug-to-lug span of this watch is a delightfully manageable 52 millimeters, with the shape of the case playing the final role in ensuring conformity to a smaller wrist. I believe down to 14.5 to 15 centimeters in circumference, you can wear this one comfortably. And it does have that wonderful lug profile again. That's half the battle. The watch is fairly slim as well. Not an ultra thin, but competitive with something like a Rolex Submariner. This is a very reasonable 13.4 millimeters thick. Rolex Submariner is about 12.6. So you're talking less than a millimeter's difference. This will slip underneath a dress cuff, certainly a suit jacket or a sport jacket or blazer sleeve, no problem. Now the strap and the clasp deserve quite a good deal of discussion because they are an integral part of the Scubatec experience, both sensually and in terms of total quality. Now you'll note that the strap is held on by screws, big, burly, threaded screws. That's what you should see on every expensive and heavy sports watch. And yet we don't. Why isn't this seen universally on watches costing 4, 5, 6 or more times what this does? I have no idea, but pennies weren't pinched here. No spring bars to be seen. Now the strap itself is reasonably flexible. You don't have to flex it much though. As you can see, it pretty much juts straight down as it exits the lugs, so it doesn't have that tendency to fight and flare and make fit difficult that you often find when the flank of a strap conforms perfectly to the end of the case. Here you get the aesthetic benefits of a very coherent and integrated design, almost the look of a watch on a bracelet, but with the flexibility and comfort of a strap, and you don't get that flare. So the watch wears true to size and true to its lug-to-lug of 52 millimeters. Now the strap is very thick, and I mean monstrously thick. This will last half a decade at minimum in service, and it's also beautifully made with a contrast between the recessed, I would call them cobalt blue components that nicely match the ceramic blue of the bezel and the black natural vulcanized rubber. Now what you also see is a channel underneath the strap on both sides to allow pockets of heat, sweat, moisture, and grit to escape the wrist on a hot day. Though you do ultimately cut the strap to precisely size it, nevertheless, the watch features a clever micro-adjustment mechanism built right into the clasp so you can incrementally adjust it for about 1 centimeter or 10 millimeters to get a precise fit, or simply to tailor on a hot day when your wrist might expand, or a cold day when it may contract. Now, because it has a sequential clasp that closes in a 1-2 order, that is to say, you can't close this side and then close this side, what you effectively get, and Ulysse Nordin has done the same thing, by creating a sequential closure, you create a dive extension. So now you have that micrometric adjustment if you need it, but you also have what is effectively a dive extension, and a clasp that is so physically massive, it rivals the best from Rolex. You'll also note that it's nicely finished. Satin finish on the flanks and the top with a beautiful polished hairline bevel that runs both sides of the clasp. Inside, very supple, curved to match the curved underside of your wrist, and when closed sequentially, very robust. With polished twin triggers, you must press the triggers to open it. It cannot simply pop open, and Bucherer did not resort to a cheaper cop-out of a clamshell closure. True trigger actuation, the way it should be in all cases. Speaking of cases, this one is immense. Physically immense and immensely beautiful. Now you'll note that the grain, the satin finish, the case flank is a little bit different. They did a vertical satin finish across the case band on both sides to set it apart from the innumerable watches that use a horizontal satin finish. You will notice a helium escape valve. This watch comes with that saturation diving mandatory feature as standard. So whether you need it or it's simply a fun discussion point and luxury is about getting more than you need, it's present and correct to make the most of the money you spend on this watch. Now, keep in mind, it's also 500 meters water resistant, so you get a watch that is perhaps more comparable in its equipment and specification to something like a Rolex Sea Dweller than the Rolex Submariner. Now, the bezel can't be missed, both because it's huge and red gold, and because it features a handsome series of blue and black ceramic inlays, so it has long-wearing durability thanks to the ultra-hard ceramic. It has a wonderful knurling. You can see it uses a narrow knurled pattern with intermediate wide spacings and a beautiful grain. You'll note that even this is satin finished to provide contrast with the polished lip of the bezel just above. It's almost artistically executed to a point that seems out of place on a tool watch, not in the sense that you wish it weren't there or it doesn't feel right, but in the sense that you feel like you're wearing a much more expensive watch than you are. So no corners cut, you can line up the bezel, which has a wonderful detent and ratcheting action, enough to prevent accidental movement, not so much that you wouldn't be able to manipulate it with wet or sweaty hands. Line up the pearl, which is incredibly large and generous, with these extended arrow-style rose gold hands at center, and there will be a loom shot. Stay tuned to the end of the video. Now you have a 0 to 60 minute countdown timer. I prefer a dive bezel to a chronograph because I tend to time short things of less duration than 1 hour. 0 to 60 minutes is fine for me. It's simpler and easier to read a minute hand against a bezel than a subregister of a chronograph. Now you can see the dial is a little bit unusual as it features a overlapping recurring manta ray pattern, and in case you have any doubt that's what it is, turn over the case. Carl F. Bucherer has been generous in its support of ocean conservation, mantas in particular, so you see mantas blazon in a rather literal format on the case back, and a more interpretive and abstract on the dial itself. The dial has a little bit of a metallic luster to it, even though it is black, and of course all of the indices are applied by hand and three-dimensional, and thus this is not a printed dial in any sense. Premium fitment, premium specification, and you get a remarkably elaborate set of crown guards and a double knurled crown. You can actually see it has two rows of knurling and intermediate fitment of blue rubber, so color coordinated even there. The details are immense. The thought is incredible, and you'll note intermediate media blasted and polished Bucherer logo on the head of the crown and polished knurled ridges on the barrel of the crown. It is a pleasure to use, and it is very secure. Some crowns feel spindly, they feel loose, they feel cheap. Sometimes it's all down to the stem tube and the stem specified by the brand. Here, rock solid. Now you pull the crown out, you stop the balance, you can hack the watch, synchronize to a known accurate reference time. There's also a quick set for correcting the date. It is a Salita SW200, so effectively a Salita ETA 2824, albeit finished, specified, and regulated to COSC chronometer standards. The watch is a chronometer on top of everything else. Smooth bidirectional winding, so it doesn't really have any audible rotor whir or wobble. It features a 38-hour power reserve. And of course, 500 meters water resistant, you have a tank tough movement in a tank tough vessel. A submersible for your wrist, but more of a luxury submersible, the kind you'd find on the fantail of a yacht rather than some. All right, cross comparison, more than you bargained for. On the right, Carl F. Bucherer Patravi Scubatec. On the left, Rolex Submariner, latest generation, 116610. You can't see it, but this one's actually the Hulk. That's how they stack up in the dark. See them in the light on our website.